The logical expression y is equal to a plus a bar b is equivalent to, and this can be find, that is a into 1 plus b, that is 1 plus b is equal to 1. So add 1 plus b plus a bar b, that is equal to a plus a b plus a bar b. So now consider this two term, a plus, take b outside, a plus a bar, and we know this is equal to 1. So answer is a plus b. So here the answer is y is equal to a plus b. Next question, the output of the logic gate in the figure is, and here the second input is always grounded, so the value of second input is always 0. So for XOR gate, this is a XOR gate, so the logic for XOR gate is 0 0 0. This is input and this is input to input, and this is output, means 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0. So any one of the input is 1, the output is 1. Both the values are 0 or both the inputs are 1, we get 0 output. So now the second input is always 0. So it follows either this A may be 1 or 0. Now this A is equal to 1, output is 1. Now A is equal to 0, output is 0. So it follows the A value. So F is equal to A. So here the value is C. And next question, find the equivalent of this octal number, and here we have to convert this number to hexadecimal number system. So here the solution is 1 to 17 base 8, and here this is 8 octal number system that can be represented as 2 power 3. So each number in octal number system we write using 3 binary bit. So 7 is represented as 111, and 1 is represented as 001, and 2 is represented as 010, and again 1001. So this is 1217. And this equivalent of hexadecimal, that is 2 to the power 4. So we group 4 4 bit. So we take this 4 bit and this 4 bit and this 4 bit. So now the value of this is 15, that is F in hexadecimal value, and this one is 100, that is 8, and this one is 0010, that is 2. So the equivalent value in hexadecimal is 028F hexadecimal. So here the answer is B. Next question, what is the Boolean expression A XOR B equivalent to, and this is XOR gate, we know A bar B plus A B bar. So this is XOR gate. So here the answer is B. Next question, what is the Boolean expression A plus B into A plus B bar equal to, and here A plus B into A plus B bar. So that is equal to A into A plus A into B bar plus B into A plus B into B bar. So this is 0, B into B bar 0. So we will get A into A, that is A, plus A B bar plus B A. This becomes 0. So taking this and this term, taking A out, we will get 1 plus B plus A B bar. So 1 plus B is 1, so we will get A plus A B bar. So again take A out, we will get 1 plus B bar. So this become 1, so we will get the answer as A. So here the answer is B. Next question, which of the following are universal gates, NAND, NOR or XOR? And here NAND and NOR, both are known as universal gates. So here the answer is A, 1 and 2. Next question, the 2's complement representation of minus 5, 3, 9 base 10 in hexadecimal is. So the equivalent of this 5, 3, 9 is 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So we have to find minus 5, 3, 9. So we have to take the 2's. So that is equal to
1. So find 2's complement now. 1 1 0 1 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 0 inverse operation. Then we have to add 1 in LSP side. So adding 1 we will get 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 1 0 1 1. So the equivalent of hexadecimal, so we have to take 4 4 bits. So we will get 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 and 1 1 0 1 1.
So this is equal to 5 and this is equal to E in hexadecimal and this is equal to D.
2's complement representation of a 16 bit number, 1 sign bit and 15 magnitude bits is F. Its magnitude in decimal representation is, and this is a question from GATE 1993. So here the representation is F. So this F can be written as 1 1 1 1 1 1 and 1 1 1, and also this 1 1 1. So taking 2's complement means taking inversion first and adding 1. So this will give remaining all are zeros. So this is the answer of 1. So here the answer is B. Next question, 4 bit 2's complement representation of a decimal number is 1000, the number is, and this is a question from GATE 2002. So first, this is first number is 1, so this is a negative number, so minus. So if you take the 2's complement means first inversion, next adding 1, 0001, so this is a representation of 8. So here the answer is minus 8. So answer is D. Next question, the decimal 43 in hexadecimal and BCD number system is respectively. This is a question from GATE 2005. So the decimal 43. So first we have to convert this 43 to binary. For that we divide this 43 by 2. And this 2 and 1 remaining is 1. And also 2, 10 remaining is 1, 2, 5. 0 remaining 0, 2, 2, 1, and this 2, 1 and 0. So the equivalent 43 equivalent is 1. From this we have to write, that is 1 0 1 0 1 1. So this is the representation of 43 in binary number system, and we have to find the hexadecimal. Hexadecimal means 16. So that is 2 power 4. So 2 power 4 means we have to take 4 4 numbers. So this is 2, remaining 2 2's we have to add, 0 0 1 0 and 1 0 1 1. So this is 3. So this is B value, that is 11, that is equal to B in hexadecimal, and this is 2. So 2B in hexadecimal, the value is 2B. So the binary BCD number system, we have to write 4 digit for each number, 4 binary bit for each number. 4 means it can be represented as 0 1 0 0. So 3 means 0 0 1 1. So this is the BCD form of this 43. So here the answer hexadecimal is 2B and BCD is 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 1. So here the answer is B. Next question, the number of bytes required to represent the decimal number 1856357 in back PCD form is, and this is a question from GATE 2014. So byte means it requires 8 bits to represent. So this number can be represented as, this 1 can be represented as 0001, 8 is 100, and 5 is 0101, and 6 is 0110, 3 is 0011, 5 0101, and 7 is 0111. So byte mean it takes 8 bit to represent. So this 8 bit and this 8 bit and this 8 bit and remaining 4 bit added 0 in front of this number. So totally 1 2 3 4 bytes. 4 bytes are required to represent this number. So here the answer is D, 4 bytes. So question x, y, and this is a function of this x, y input, and we will get 0, 0, 0 output, 0, 1, 0 output, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. The truth table represents the Boolean function, and this is a GATE Computer Science 2012 question. This truth table, we can find this f of function of this x and y, that is output follows the x value. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. So here f is equal to x. So the answer is A.